Right, this is Spargo back again. Probably sick of hearing me talking about artificial intelligence now. This one's about the wrap up. Just kind of pulling everything together, looking at the two different types of AI as required by A-level computer science. Okay, so the big question for this video basically is we're thinking about what are the issues surrounding the use of AI. So we kicked off with actually looking at what is artificial intelligence, and we talked about intelligence being the ability to solve. Resolve a situation it, when it's an uncertain or an unknown environment. Okay, you don't know actually you've never solved this particular problem before, but you've got enough background knowledge and enough new to figure out how to kind of solve it and preserve yourself, etc. Okay, we looked at how computers find things hard because they find it very difficult to judge a situation to work out what the best possible conclusion. Should be in order to resolve it. So the two main approaches that we talked about were knowledge-based systems, which attempt to emulate expert behavior by capturing knowledge from experts. The great advantage for them is they are very good in a narrow domain because they have good factual knowledge. The knowledge engineer may have captured the tricks that an expert uses in order to solve a particular problem. However, these knowledge-based systems cannot cope with unexpected data or with new knowledge. Okay. Adaptive systems like neural networks, the assumption is that a computer can learn from data and it can train itself, just like humans learn from their environment around them and create conclusions and adapt and become better at solving problems. Okay, so neural networks basically can apply what they have learned when the data is changed, so they can adapt to a changing environment, which is in clear contrast to a knowledge-based system. However, they can be very, very slow to train. They may not even be successful making it through the training process. All right. So, some things to think about with AI. Okay. So you may know about the Turing test, where you have a computer or a person in a room, and you have a person in another room down the hall, or wherever it is. They basically can't see who they're talking to, and according to Alan Turing, a computer would have achieved intelligence if it was able to trick a person into not knowing whether they were talking to a computer or a person. All right. They have these kind of competitions once a year. I think last year, the year before, I can't remember when, there was this big hoo-ha about OA computers passed the Turing test, etc. You will find that chatbots basically make extensive use of rooms to have conversations with people. So chatbots like those that are used in a Turing test and may appear to be intelligent. However, you will find that when nothing matches what they have been trained with, then they start to give odd responses. It is really worth actually just YouTubing Cleverbot versus Cleverbot and watching it. It's quite funny because there's lots of weird conversations where chatbots are talking to themselves. Chatbots can also be used for malicious purposes to trick people into giving up sensitive data online, and that raises further questions. So I'll come on to those in a minute. If we also think about, before we move on, digital assistants. So for example, things like Siri or Google Assistant or Amazon Echo or Cortana, right? They are getting much, much better, but actually how good are they? So when we talk about AI, actually being effective and solving problems and so on and so forth. They're very, very good at very, very specific things, but they're not good at lots of things like humans. For example, like Teslas and self-driving. They might be good at self-driving, but that's pretty much all they can do. They can't pick up a football and start playing with, a bunch of other people. So, in terms of legal issues, who's responsible for the behavior of an AI? So if that chatbot starts acting in a, it's harvesting information from people to then be used for malicious purposes, who's responsible for it? It's interesting because new UK legislation basically is going to make the owner of a self-driving car, if it's involving an accident, liable, and they will have to pay from their own insurance. Whereas what happens if that accident was actually caused by a fault from the manufacturer's software? All right. So, there are legal issues there that perhaps are not so clear. All right. I mean, you may think that actually, if it's a fault with the software, then shouldn't the car manufacturer be liable, not the person who bought the car? Because they may not even, in the future, they may not, people may not even have driving licenses because the cars are handling everything for them. In terms of moral and ethical issues, if true AI is achieved, can it be turned off? So you may have seen Ghost in the Shell, and this is a bit of the scene where they are investigating the android that has been in a car accident, and then the android basically wakes itself up and then demands asylum because it is an AI and is intelligent. And there's an argument about whether an AI can be granted political asylum or not, because it's not a human, and therefore by denying humanity, you're basically denying that the AI has needs. So if we do ever achieve AI, would it be ethical to keep a slave race subservient to human needs? Obviously, there's a big furor about slavery, past and present, and would it be ethical, if we achieved AI, to keep computers subservient to humans? And there's lots of science fiction stories and movies and etc. about that. Cultural issues. We also have changing behavior patterns. So basically, I'm quite reliant on my smartphone because Google now provides me with a whole host of information. Agenda, when I get to work or I get to home, at certain times my reminders pop up, so I don't basically remember anything nowadays. I just rely on my phone to remind me of what I need to be reminded about at the right time. Provides me with information, tells me about traffic, tells me how long it's to take to get to work, tells me to leave work early because there's been an accident on the way home. All right. You know, all sorts of stuff comes out of Google, you know, out of these intelligent agents, for example. Also, about news. We've seen some example of this where you have your news being selectively presented to you by intelligent agents and social media, and actually just because you read one link, it starts suggesting more links that are the same, and you get trapped in an echo chamber where you don't see a balance of news from different sources presenting different opinions, so you can make a balanced and informed decision about something. Your view gets skewed to one particular polemic, and we saw that with Brexit, perhaps with Donald Trump and his election as well. So you should actually be able to now, you should be quite clear on what AI is and the pros and cons of the two different approaches to developing AI. And you should also understand some of the issues that surround the use of AI and be able to expand on that further.